This is one of many Chinese villages that recently left extreme poverty behind. A few years ago, Erhaobu was considered one of the country's poorest villages, even though it is not far from Beijing. Young people are still lured to the big cities, leaving behind the older generation to make a living in farming. Liu Fang is in her 40s, but she's one of the youngest farmers who've remained here. She's showing us the traditional way of watering plants in her tiny garden, but about 2 years ago, she turned to drones.
看人家地里打药，那飞机都能打药，那有那种的。就现在就前几天嘛，我们地里也起了那个虫子，就是车进不去了，人工打。人工打一下打不完，好几天。但是那个东西一天一夜就长好多，那庄稼咬着就不像了。飞机打一亩5块钱，一会儿就打完了。
Leo takes me to her field where a team is using a drone to water her crops. After measuring the area, the pilot activates the drone with one tap of her smartphone. The drone can water this plot, about 2 hectares, in less than 2 hours. With one farmer, it'd take 3 days, and the technology cuts the cost by more than half. The use of the drone has increased Liu's crop yields by about 20%, which means an extra income of $3,000 a year can be invested in her child's education.
我觉得它不仅可以推广新的技术嘛，它也可以加速农村现代化的发展，使农民的就是那个工作环境更安全，因为它不用自己去背药壶了，只要他学会自己操作无人机，他就可以控制了嘛，这样就解决了他的就业问题。所以对于这个行业，我觉得不仅是可以解决就是就业问题，它也可以就是技术扶贫嘛。
Agricultural drones were adopted in China about 10 years ago, and their popularity has grown since 2017. Drone manufacturers hope this technology will help create a new generation of farmers.
With the autonomous technology, an individual farmer now can manage more and more bigger and bigger farms. So the income for them will substantially increase as well. And this will attract the young generation people return to the farmland to choose farmer as a profession for their career. And this will also bring back the young blood back to the rural community to boost the economy too.
Across farms in China, this is becoming a more familiar scene, with every drone that takes to the skies an ally in the battle against rural poverty.